Now that we've talked about measures of central tendency like mean, median, and mode, now it's time to talk about another way of measuring a variable, and that's variability. What we're talking about here is how varied a variable is from person to person. Some people have high scores and some people have low scores. In a given sample, you might have people who have very similar scores. For example, in a college population, everyone's around 18 to 22 years old and has very little variability. But if you looked at the city of Norman, Oklahoma, for example, you have people who are 1 year old, you have people who are 100 years old. Variability is very wide. The variance of a variable is the thing that we're really interested in because we're trying to explain the variation in the variable eventually. What we need to know is something about how varied a variable is. So how varied are people from the mean is a great way of looking at this. So we have a typical sample and people are at the mean. Some people are above the mean, some people are below the mean. And the idea here is to know how far away people are from the mean, to get some single measurement that tells us about that. That's what variance is. Now, variance is one way of measuring it, but there's another variable called standard deviation. And Mitch is going to teach you about how to calculate that, and that's the variable that we use a lot in other statistics later on. So we'll start with learning about variance and variation, and then we'll move towards learning about standard deviation. So let me give you a really concrete example. When I go golfing, for example, I notice that the people that I play with have a lot of variability in their skills. Some people hit the ball all over the place. Some people hit the ball exactly where they're aiming. They can hit the ball 3 and 4 and 5 times and they all land kind of in the same area, where another person hits the ball and there's one over here, there's one over there, there's one that dribbles off the tee box, and we have no idea where that ball's going. That's a great example of variance. People are taking shots and their shots will be tightly grouped around the target that they're aiming at. Other people will take shots and their shots will be grouped all over the place. We have no idea where those balls are going. What we want to do when we calculate standard deviation and variance is get one number that represents how varied the group is. A set of golf shots that has a very tight clustering will have a small variance and a small standard deviation. A group that has a large clustering will have a high variance or a high standard deviation. So let's look at an example here. All right, so I went out to the OU golf course and I'm actually working here with my friend Vero, and she and I are going to hit some shots for you and see if we can show you what variance looks like. All right, Vero's going to hit some balls now with the 8-iron. Let's look at Vero's results. You'll see that her shots are all clustered very closely together. The furthest that she went was about 132 yards, and her shortest shot was about 118 yards, and they're all very tightly clustered together, just a little bit right of center. And if you look at it from this angle, you'll see all of her shots went in the same direction. The trajectory is all very similar. The lowest of her shots got about 22 yards in the air, and the highest got about 34 yards in the air. And they're all very similar. You see a lot of similarity here. So you would say her variance or her standard deviation is probably going to be very small. All right, let's look at my results. Not quite as good. You'll see that I have one of my shots went all the way off of the driving range, all the way over to the right-hand side. You'll see it in the dark green area there. And my other shots are all over the place. I've got one shot that went over 150 yards. I have one that went about 88 yards. And so my shots are everywhere, some to the left of the center, some to the right of center. This is a great example of a high variance or a large standard deviation. I have a varied shot pattern. All right, let's look at my trajectory compared to Vero's. So, not so good. A couple of my shots only got about 8 yards off the ground. A couple of them got as high as 32 yards off the ground. But I'm clearly all over the place. And then look at the bottom of the screen. You see how I'm spread out from left to right. I'm spraying my shots everywhere. I clearly have no idea where my 8-iron is going. Again, I have a lot of variability in my shots. So I hope that's a great example for you about how variability and standard deviation plays a role in all of our everyday lives. I hope that you find a way that helps you make sense of variation and standard deviation just like I did. For me, golf makes perfect sense. For you, it might be something else. Try to think about a way that variation and standard deviation plays a role in your life.